What I hope to do in this video is a reasonably quick justification of the idea that the absolute value of a minus b is equal to the absolute value of b minus a for any two numbers a or b. And before I even break into this, I want to start with a simpler proposition. The idea that if I have some number x, that the absolute value, and I'm just using x since I already used up a and b, that the absolute value of x is going to be the same thing as the absolute value of negative x. And to feel good about this, we could draw a number line. So we could draw a number line. And this is 0. So there's one circumstance in which x is positive. Obviously, if x was 0, then these are both going to be equal to 0, and it would be true. But one world where x is positive, then negative x would be the same distance to the left of 0. So negative x would be here. And the absolute value of x would be this distance. And the absolute value of negative x would be that same distance, but just to the left. So these two things would be equivalent. Now if x were negative, so let me draw that. So if x were negative, so if this was x, then what would negative x be? Well, negative x would be the opposite of it. So it would be the same distance to the right of 0. So I know this looks weird, me putting the negative x out here. But remember, x could be negative 2. And if x is negative 2, then negative 2 is going to be positive. But either way, you see that the absolute value of these two things are the same. The absolute value is just the distance from 0. This distance is still going to be the same as this distance. This distance is the absolute value of x. This distance, in this case, is the absolute value of negative x. So hopefully you feel good that these two things are equivalent. Now, if you agree to that, now let's work on this a little bit. So we can start with the absolute value of a minus b. And there's a bunch of ways that we could tackle this. But one way we can approach it is, and actually let me write a little lower so I don't bump into this stuff right over here. So let me start with the absolute value of a minus b. Now a, we could rewrite, this is a positive, or this is just a. I don't want to say it's positive or negative. A could be a negative number. But this is just a right over here. But we can rewrite this as being the same thing as negative a, or I guess negative a plus, or let me write this, minus b. So let's just think about this a little bit and make sure we feel comfortable with what I just did. So this a is the same thing as all of this business, the negative a. The negative of a negative is going to be a positive. This is positive a. So I haven't changed this in any dramatic way. But what's this going to be the same thing as? Well, we can factor out a negative sign. So let's do that. And actually, we could factor out, just in a color that I haven't used yet. We could factor out the negative signs. So this is going to be equal to the absolute value of, I can factor out the negatives. The negative of, and then I have open parentheses, negative a. And if you factor out a negative here, this is going to be positive b. So, or plus b. And let me just close the parentheses in the same color just to make the match. Now, why is this interesting? Well, we just said the absolute value of a negative is the same thing as the absolute, if the absolute value of negative x is the same thing as the absolute value of x. So the absolute value of the negative of negative a plus b is going to be equal to, this is going to be equal to the absolute value, let me do that yellow color, it's going to be equal to the absolute value of this thing without the negative written here. You see that right over here? The absolute value of negative x is the same thing as the absolute value of x. So the absolute value of negative a plus b is the same thing as the absolute value of negative a plus b. Negative a plus b plus b. And negative a plus b, well, that's the same thing as b minus a. I'm just swapping the order right over here. b minus b minus a. And we're done. We've just shown that the absolute value of a minus b is the same thing as the absolute value of b minus a. And obviously, hopefully you already felt pretty good about it by just trying out a bunch of numbers and thinking about the number line and thinking about what the difference of two numbers mean if one is larger than the other. But this is, we're just literally just really factoring out a negative sign here and recognizing this property up here to make the same conclusion.